friends, we wrote this script, this play we're going to perform for you with these amazing... Oh, finally, the Rick is here, I have to say. Yes!
Oh, God, I don't know if it's such a good idea to have him in our audience.
Hey, I need you to take that the negativity and shove it way up inside your head hole. Way up inside your head hole. But, you know, we'll just do Rick and Morty for the rest of the show. Welcome to Low Budget Rick and Morty Hour. So we're about to do this play. We stayed up all night long ingesting lots of air, pure air.
Much air. Woo, God.
Great air. And we wrote this script. It was called, what did we name by?
It was James Cameron's Point Blank. The Search for Curly's Gold.
Right. You cannot even imagine everything. It's 170-ish pages of solid
book. Incredible. I'm going to go get it right now. We had to turn it into Sir Reginald, the Standards and Practices. Going to waste no time because we're going to need every precious second for all this insanity.
For this strangeness.
Whoa, so,
that's right.
Yeah.
So, this is a cutaway, my friends. It has everything you could possibly want in a story. It has robots, it has children running from robots, it has a hot robot on scientist action, it has Ryan Reynolds wearing the Deadpool mask, but that's it. Nothing else. Just hanging meat, just for like. With the illustrations as well, it took at least 4 or 5 pages. It's amazing. We will show you the storyboards.
Is there blood?
Oh, there is. There will be blood, but not that boring movie kind. Where Daniel Day-Lewis just phoned it in. No, not that one. Not that one.
That son of a bitch. No.
Why do you sound big in Italian?
Every time. Every time.
Uh-oh. I can't win. It's impossible.
What happened?
So I get into Sir Reginald's office.
Right.
He has like 1,000 pounds right in front of me.
Ooh.
Do you know what a casting couch is?
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. I mean, how am I supposed to know? When we in German, we say everything literally. It's called a banging sofa.
Right. What was it? The crusty couch?
The crusty couch.
Exactly. Right.
We use everything particularly literally in German. So how am I supposed to know the casting couch means just...
So he tricked you into...
Fisting the brown eye, as it
were. No! Again?
The fist of the North Star. He was
no!
Just... Right inside my butthole, just...
No, he was... Wow, we have to live with that forever. He's wily. I mean, I'll give him... He's a smart
guy. He gave me this script, and as soon as I was able to walk, I got back here.
That was really fast. I'm looking at my invisible watch to dictate that.
He's not a man with very high endurance, you know.
Oh, wow.
It is time. Yes.
Hey.
That's right. I played the Song of Storms to speed him up. And then it just rains.
The tears.
Oh, you showed him the windmill, right?
All right. The Chinook, the
Captain. Oh, the Chinook.
That one, don't try that one at home, you might hurt yourself.
All right, so blah, 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 we took your play, blah, 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 search for Coley's gold, blah, blah, blah.
Give me the important things.
And a bunch of the crippling addiction to bad puns, the hell?
Well, that's weird.
And so I actually made a literal cutting of your script.
Oh, dude, no, come
Wait,
on.
Is that what?
No.
Is that what?
That can't be.
That cannot be what?
Oh, it was like a stack of pages, like these little...
Just one cotton picking mint.
I swear, if he... No, that sounds like paper. Oh my! I'm literally angry with Rich.
Yo, that's a play! That's definitely our play! That was one piece of Ryan Reynolds' dong.
No!
That was one piece of Ryan Reynolds' dong.
Was it the tip?
Just for a second.
Barely.
Just for a second.
Barely. Just a tip for a
second.
What the hell, though?
It was a masterpiece and it ruined.
Yeah, so I mean, so they took a little cutting of your script. I've sorted a treatment plan, all right.
Oh, well,
And the first step is admitting my shortcomings. Well, I already knew
it.
That.
He's four or five. He's a whisper man.
But I mean, at his age, stamina must be an issue. I suppose it happens to the best of us. Am I right when I just can't
help? Ladies here today, I would like to say at this point, maybe the Germans and English, they have stamina issues, but not as far as ladies. I am, like how you say in English, a rack of ribs.
Oh, how so?
Usually good for at least 8 to 12 bones. That's freshly baked comedy, I
swear. Oh, God, it's all in there. Time to make the comedy. We already made the comedy. Every day we make fresh comedy. Like two or three people are of the generation of that commercial. I'm not even of the generation of that commercial. It's Time Travelers Weekend, all right.
Yes. Predate us. How do we do that?
You see those two fuzzies that were walking by? I think they time traveled from an era where it's socially acceptable to dress like that.
Oh, gross. Continue.
Therefore, I must also apologize to everyone who I have wronged with my crippling addiction. What the hell? That's
a lot of names.
It's a huge list. Stan Lee.
Let me help you hold this.
See, the master of the method. Count Dooku, he's dead. He's been dead for a while.
You know what? He crossed out Bill Cosby. Thank God for that.
Yes. We will never apologize to Dr. Cosby again.
No, he tricked me once, but not twice. I learned this move. Yes. Done me a lot.
We can hate him all we want, but for some reason we can't take away his honorary doctorate. Oh. Take it away.
Dirty, dirty Bill.
Oh.
Continue pretending to read.
This is not as easy as it looks.
I believe it is.
I have the scry vision. It's the only way. It says speak, friend, and enter, yeah?
You're a multi-classer.
But this way, yeah, I am a multi-classer.
Galactus.
Indeed. And then I must also give thee a gift so that I may make amends for ruining thy day. And I hope that these gifts.
I hope it doesn't call a gift that the remnants of our script. I hope there's
no gold. There's no gold in here. I can't feel any. Sir, would you feel my sack for a second?
Just cradle it.
Ow! Not so hard, just cradle it.
Yes, now look directly into his eyes. Don't break eye contact.
Don't break the eye contact.
And when it's all over, you say, oh my, what a lovely
thing. Just juggle him. Just juggle him. Shazam!
What's in there? What the hell is that?
It's a dice.
It's an icosahedron.
I don't speak German. I'm telling you this over and over again. It is a... for those of you that cannot see in the back, it is a D.
Oh, it is a D.
It is a D. Oh.
So Reginald gave us his tiny D.
Reginald.
I miss little baby D.
It's so tiny, but the D looks so tenacious.
I know. but he's really small. He's not just a small D. That, my friend, is a micro D.
Oh, yeah, a micro D. I read about these in the Buzzard Feed articles.
Oh, poor Reginald, he's a micro D. Why does the Lady Bear look so happy? There's no way he's scoring critical hits with that micro D.
Right! This is awful. I mean, you can boop, and then just a little. I mean, it is life science, though. I mean, I felt it personally.
That is true. So we have a remnant of script, and we have this Reginald's baby D. How do we turn this into a thing for all these people that come to see?
Think of a thing. Okay, we can get some midgets together, and we can get a lot of pandas, and right. Maybe. Where are we gonna get pandas?
At this time of the hour? Nowhere.
We can just murder a bunch of children.
Not again. Yeah.
Do any of them have red shirts on?
You're the first ones to die. Wait, so...
Does it count?
I don't know, I...
No, you just got a little red on you.
Just a bit of red.
Got a lot of red on us.
Well, my friends, I apologize. I'm afraid there is no hope.
Aww.
No.
Right, a new one.
There is another.
Oh,
Xavier?
Yeah?
It don't occur to me that we have been shoving our giant D's in people's faces.
Right, right. Let's not go to prison again. I serve my neck and I'm done. Wait, there. Our man-sized D, this something is happening to my brain. It is, it's like a headache, but with pictures.
An idea!
Yes. I'm having an idea. There, I have to tell you a thing. Look, long ago, the ancient Druidish people, remember them with the robes and the long
hair? Oh yeah, the Druish people!
Right, they used to perform these rituals. In the shadowy wooden areas, they would gather and perform these things with the robes, and they would drink fermented saps of ancient oaks, and they would throw animal knuckle bones into these big stone circles of power to help guide and influence the hands of fate.
Oh my god, that is so hardcore.
I know, right?
Yeah, it's pretty hardcore. Yeah, I'd say it's pretty hardcore.
Yeah, it's pretty hardcore. I think it's pretty hardcore too. Stop copying me. Stop copying me. I'm sorry, what? I just had a Cusack moment.
I have to tell you, the whole reason for me to tell you this is the practice is carried on today, but missing some of the dramatic flair it once had.
Yeah,
come today. Yeah. Well, today is mostly practiced by culturally misunderstood men or women who may or may not live in their parents' basement. Or with that spot above their garage they call their apartment. You know, that is.
Oh, yeah, so they get the rent free and all amenities.
Mom, hot pockets! That devil thing. And also, they don't use animal knuckle bones or stone circles, it's regular dice. And they don't drink fermented saps, mostly cold red.
Oh, I have seen these new Druids. The beard has gone from here down to here.
Right, it is migrating. They are now neck beards.
Big neck and, beard, yeah.
Right. They are fully neck bearded.
Oh, I met a man who was not of the neck beards once.
You did?
He was something awful.
Oh, he sounded like a goon to me.
Sounds like a goon.
Oh, what are you?
One solid goon. Yes.
We have shamed one goon. Yeah.
How do you agree for goon? Reference him.
That's right. His house is well defended, I'm sure. Don't worry. There's rules for this. I never leave my house without my comically oversized core rule book.
Oh my god.
Yes. I know. Don't worry. Friends, it is edition 2.5, a 4.0, not 2.5. Whoa, I mixed up in head.
A 4.0? So we took out all the math?
Right, oh wait, do you want to go one more?
One more, can we go to 5.0?
Let me see. Yes, we go to 5.
Oh, I'm so glad.
It's not 2.5 because we don't have 3 weeks to make a character.
We don't have 8 separate books in front of us.
Our manuals, our manual.
What are you talking about? This is amazing. I had no idea you could use this for such incredible ends. I mostly just use these for butt stuff.
Whoa, dude, I had the nick on my face. What the hell are you doing me?
What? What's wrong?
I was about to, I was holding it like this. You couldn't touch my face. You just said butt stuff.
I just said butt stuff. Right. Oh. In English, it's called Magic the Gathering.
He could show you later, it's quite disappointing.
It's a roll down dice.
You would regret tapping it, I assure you. Right there, so the ancient ritual had this long Druish name. It was like, Laven, 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 something like this. But now we just call it D&D for short.
Woo! Here we are.
So, you want to expand this work?
What about even though I'm just being introduced to this, we will require these dice, this book, and the participation of you goodly gentles!
Yeah!
Now, in a moment, we will have one of you come up and roll the giant D so that we can get our show on the road. But before that, we'll add a lot of questions asking if they more people can participate in the game and or buy us booze.
Right.
And so we thought we could combine the two ideas, and anytime during the game that we're playing, you buy a beer for us at the bar, you can interrupt us and change what happened.
That's right, that you tell. You tell the lovely bartenders that you are also tipping, you are totally tipping them.
Yes,
and not just the tip, not that thing, actual money in the cup.
And become DM for a minute, or a second.
You can change a thing, you can make us re-roll a thing, you can change our class, You can have him do the whole show with one less arm or something. I don't know. But that's the point.
One less arm, but no less clothing.
Right.
Write your letters! Write your letter! I really wanted Dieter to go pantsless this show!
Come back around Halloween time, we will do the no pants one of Halloween. We will say it's a costume.
Yeah, the love and no pants weekend.
So, how did you do it, my friends? It's being manifested campaign before your very eyes. Using the help of you and this man who's going to be buying a beer right now. Yeah!
All right. Derby to judge or something. They ran out of IPA in the kegs.
Who would like to be the first one to come down and visit?
Yes! Whoa! Wow. That was fierce.
All right, then you're the first war cries, aren't you the first one? Come on down, my friend.
Yeah, all right,
okay, get him.
Woo! Here he goes. What is your
name? Say your name into my breast, sissies. Do it.
Whoa.
Everyone, this is Dylan. It's here for
Dylan. Dylan. That's the five best rappers in the world. Dylan, 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 and Dylan.
He's spitting hot fire right now. So, Dylan, roll the dice, keep it on the Andrew Dice tray, and we shall see what class the pair shall be. You have a spinny technique, that's weird. I question your
ladies talent. Love the spinning, and that's why it's a 17.
17? Right, is...
We're not questioning your medic,
a cleric!
Oh.
I'm a cleric! Oh, but you can get the optional plus or minus two.
Oh, you are the dealer's choice today,
or? We're not going pantsless, minus two.
Minus two?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was going to be one, minus one. Let's do that. I don't want to do Ranger.
It's boring.
It's the worst one.
You know, give it up, man. Make it audience choice. Let's make it audience choice. Now, what
you can
do you want?
You can
read. David Bowie.
You've been one of the booth.
All right. It has come down to the booth or Bowie. Who wants to see the booth cheer?
Do it.
Who wants to see David Bowie cheer?
You're a star man, baby.
I guess that solves a super funky problem.
All right, so my friend, now he shall be the normal class of David Bowie. And roll it to see what I shall be, and that we will change to something else. And it is a two.
A two? Which is a sentient wad of meat.
That would be a sentient wad of meat.
So the wad of meat is talking.
Wow, that's really meta. I'm like actually a sentient wad of meat. Hang on. Alright, now my friend, we shall determine, we need to have something that is wrong with us that is not.
Even though there's no flaws in a Bowie.
Right.
We need to create one.
So you roll the dice and determine what foible David Bowie has, because we know he has none, so we have to make one up. Roll D12, everyone be on the lookout for Eminem, and we shall see. Hey! Hurry up, one hip hop fan, alright!
If you buy us a beer, you can choose.
Take forever. What is it, five?
Five! I have a rational paranoia.
Oh my god, what is that behind me? I'm lost in my own labyrinth.
Use your card piece, Bowie. Use your magic card piece.
Alright, now I want to find out what else is wrong with me that I'm actually a Sunday midwife. It's still rolling, what do you know? Amazing.
That's what got you in the NBA finals.
That's right. Seven.
Seven, which is... You're a condescending dickbag.
You're pretty good at rolling up dials. That's what I'm a compliment.
Oh, that's going to be awkward. Alright, since you are doing the whole thing, we shall continue. So now, we know what we shall be. Now we need to have a campaign plot, something that ties whatever the hell this is going to be together. So, roll this D12 again, and we shall find out what our story shall be today, my friends.
And now there can be this story, or you can buy a beer and have many changes.
I want the fur con!
Roll it again. Oh, God.
You want the fur con to happen?
He wants to watch me puke for the whole show.
Hold on a sec! What do you drink?
Oh. And then I can have it after we're done slinging metal at each other.
Right. Make sure you're specific. We only like beer-flavored beer.
Yeah, not IPA.
No.
And,
I want to chew it.
Yeah, I'd like to be able to chew my beer.
Right, so our friend will be, I guess, choosing...
What did you want to change?
What do you want to make it?
Farcon!
Our noble hero, David Bowie, is out to stop the evil sentient wad of meat from creating his own fur cob.
I just can't stand how those people get together in sandboxes and give. They just give the day away.
Oh, I'm gonna throw so much. Okay, all right, you guys said. So now, we shall determine what our hero's first encounter shall be. And then we shall determine how it will happen and we will get underway. So, I'll roll this to see what he will face in his journey first.
I'm going for dwarf furry.
Stop just playing with it. Right, it is a... forever rolling. 18! Whoa!
18!
Dramatic reveal.
Ah!
A monarch!
Not in the costume play, I'm in the costume business!
Number 24!
No, Venture Brothers Masquerade! Yeah.
Where is my warrior wife?
Alright,
misses the monarch!
Alright, so now one final roll to determine what weird thing this is going to be and how it's going to go down, then we shall begin. Alright, so.
Give me one a cheer too! As it rolls!
In the water, and it's an 8.
It's an 8, which is...
A new thing.
10 tons!
All right, everyone, please give it up for our volunteer.
Our hero's journey begins. The noble David Bowie, sent out on his quest to stop the evil sentient mod of meat from creating his very own furcon. On his travels, as he sexily strode down the road, glitter shining in the sunlight, he encountered a...
What the hell was it?
A monarch.
A monarch. He encountered a monarch in the middle of the road.
I encountered an entire auditorium worth...
Of monarchs.
Of monarchs and henchmen.
So you want to explain how this person got the world?
So what I'm gonna have you do is give me a suggestion of what I should give a TED talk on, and then if I persuade you, if I touch your hearts, you cheer and I win. If I suck, you blow and I lose.
So he has to give you all a TED talk. What is the topic of it? What is he an expert on?
Dungeons and Dragons to get girls.
Henchman rights.
Henchman rights. Henchman rights.
That is too good to not know.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you David Bowie, the master of henchmen's rights, here to give you all a little talk today.
Honor, loyalty, oblivion. Are these all things that should have the common thread of henchmen? Now, people may laugh at the makeup on my face. My spiky red hair, my animal grace. But I will get up on the stage and tell you that Ziggy says henchmen deserve to have the rights that they were given when they were born. When you give away your rights to a monarch or any other person in the Guild of Calamitous Intent, it's necessary. I kicked him out months ago. Now, not that I have any direct affiliation with the Guild of Calamitous Intent. I'm certainly not the head of it or anything.
David Bowie, you have one. You have 10 seconds. Wrap this up. 10 seconds.
And in conclusion, what I want you to know is that you're not just henchmen, but we can be heroes.
All right, everyone. Has he persuaded you? Yeah.
Our hero has persuaded the sea of monarchs with this beautiful TED Talk on henchmen appreciation.
I just bought a beer.
So did I lose?
I want you to talk about Wookiee's rights.
Ladies and gentlemen, for double the loot, David Bowie is going to give a 30-second talk on Wookiee rights. Let's get kishicked.
Ewoks. Wookiees. Are they the same animal, or are you simply a racist? Have you ever looked into the eyes of a Wookiee and said, hey man, I feel where you're coming from. And where you're coming from is pretty far out, man. Have you ever looked at an Ewok and said, you're getting a little too much bang for your buck. And so my plan that I propose to you is that in 5 years, the Wookiees will have rights. 5 years, there'll be no more fights. 5 years. 5 years.
The hero has doubled his pleasure and therefore doubled our fun. And has won himself.
I forgot to tell you, it was double loot there anyway.
So our hero wins 4 pieces of loot. Great!
Oh, I'm so glad I
won. His first piece of loot is the WW belt! Of questionable origin!
Well, I see this and it looks nice, but it doesn't look as good as it once could have been.
John Cena!
I feel like I want to be less, like, I want to stop seeing you. That's why I want. If I could really not see you anymore, it would be wonderful, John Cena. I'm more of a...
Ooh, yeah!
Yeah! For his second piece of amazing loot...
That's a promise.
He has won himself the SCA Sword of Desperate Shaming.
Yes! Society for Creative Anachronism, where people who bruise easily go to Fight Club.
Where people who sweat while they eat.
Sweat while they eat. Rule one of SCA Fight Club. Talk about Fight Club as much as possible to people who don't care.
Rule number two. You have to have a to-the-thread count period costume, but you still gotta rock Reeboks in your own eyewear that you have to wear.
Now John Cena.
Oh! You've been de-Bowied. Continuing on with his loot wins, David Bowie magically turns into John Cena, disappointing the masses, and therefore has won a piece of loot that hopefully will redeem him, the Flavor Flav Clock of...
Oh God. All right, I guess there's absolutely no impression for John Cena because he's an ordinary white guy.
And for his final piece of loot, he has won the John Cena Parasol of Power.
You're a fancy girl.
Yeah, that's right. I'm gonna win all the rap battles against the Big Show.
All right, who would like to be next to come down and place right up on the... Who has never done it before? Wow, you have done this before, and you seem very eager. We were like, yes, you come. You are ready. What is your name? Talking to my non-existent prostheses.
Jess.
This is Jess, everyone. Yeah. You shall determine what scene I have to battle next. Are you all right,
Doctor? Hey, if the 9-time World Wrestling Entertainment Champion can't, you know that just means he lost at 8.
Oh God!
15, what? 15, so he's lost at 16.
Oh really? Did I rip Van Winkle for like five years?
Yeah. You stroked out for 5 years.
I stroked out for 5 years. Get away!
Oh, Bo, stop. All right, roll the dice and let's continue whatever this is. And it is going to be a long roll. A 16.
A 16, which is an orc.
John Cena has to fight an orc, and let's find out what strange way it's going to happen.
Morty, you got it. I don't know, she rolled up pretty hard.
These are going to be a long roll again. Come on, it's like a 45-minute show.
Talk again, I got to
do. Wait, it's still rolling, what do you know? A thing, and now it is going to be a 9.
A 9, which is
another new thing.
Oh God, I got it.
Take your time.
Actor's Nightmare!
Oh! Yeah. Everyone, please, my volunteer! Yeah. All right, the terror is going to retrieve what we need for this game, and then he will explain.
I got some parasol troubles.
You want to explain to them how this weird thing is going to
I just turned this into the John Cena Darth Maul. Darth Maul of dual shaming.
I'm double your shame.
So what we require one eager, eccentric volunteer. I gotta give it to right there. If you get up here.
Miss America, come down.
So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little role-playing scene. Ooh. And everything that I say must be responded to by a line from our previously perfect play.
That we way don't remember because of all the air we were breathing.
So much air, which is crazy because we used to be a Pepsi company.
That's right.
Our hero's journey continues, take two. Our hero's journey continues. He has won himself lots of loot, but he is not satisfied, for he has not stopped the sentient meatwads for God. So, being formerly Bowie and turned into Cena, he continues his travels, and he encounters an orc in the middle of the road.
Oh no, you're not another one of those fur guys, are you? I see you in my autograph lines all the time at Wizard World, because I read comics sometimes.
Yeah, that was pretty scary.
Wait, that says salty. That's
salty slash scary?
You better handwriting.
Whoa, I was just standing near the back.
Wow, so...
Oh, hey! Jokes, we're done. All right, let's go.
If that was scary, you should see how ridiculous my finishers are.
Well, if your mom...